Welcome to the lab portion of our MOOC. When we give this course in the classroom setting at Georgetown, what we do each week is bring the students in for laboratory demonstrations and experiments where we actually put into practice the math that we're learning. This is the first one that we're going to be doing this week, and the lab that we're going to be giving is called Shoot the Box. What we have here is a projectile launcher. The projectile launcher has a spring inside with a ball. The projectile launcher will launch the ball, and it launches the ball with the same velocity every time that it launches it. It will launch that ball out, and then the goal is to get the ball to land inside the box, which is all the way down here. What we're going to do in order to have you figure out exactly how this works is we're going to set this at horizontal, and we're going to launch the ball a number of times and figure out just how far does the ball launch. And from that, you can determine what the velocity is coming out of the launcher. Then you're going to have to calculate and tell us exactly what the angle is to set the launcher at in order to get the ball inside the box. We'll give you the dimensions of the box. We'll give you the dimensions of the launcher and the projectiles and everything that you need to know in order to figure it out just using simple kinematics, which you should already know from an introductory physics course on mechanics. What we find when we do this demonstration at Georgetown is that it is fairly easy to hit the box, but it's really quite difficult to get the ball inside the box. Typically, we have about 10 to 15 groups that are doing this, and we'll find one or two groups are actually able to make it inside the box. Let's see whether or not you are one of those groups this time. So one of the dimensions that we have is the distance from the pivot to the front edge of the box. That distance is 5 meters. So we're going to now set up the device in such a way that you can get the information you need to determine what angle you want to launch at. We've set the device at horizontal. You can see from the plumb bob that it's right at 0 degrees. We're going to launch the ball a couple of times to try and get a sense of exactly where it hits. And we're going to have to use that as the number for how far the ball goes when it hits. This device has 3 settings in it. It has a short, a medium, and a long. We're going to be setting it at the medium setting. You don't really need to know that in the sense that what the setting is doesn't matter. What really matters is what the launch velocity is. But just for consistency, the device is actually quite accurate. And when we set it on the medium setting, which we will do, the ball should be launching at about the same velocity every time. We're going to then be situating ourselves on the other end and determining where it hits. And from that, we're going to then determine what the distance is that the ball traveled when it's launched horizontally. And from that, you'll be able to determine everything you need to tell us what your predicted angle is. I should also say that when you come up with a predicted angle, you're going to have 2 choices of angle. Pick the one that is the smallest one, because the smallest one is one that we can actually put on the device here. If you pick it too high, there's nothing wrong with the machine, but in this room we have a ceiling, and we don't want the ball hitting the ceiling in trying to get into the box. So when you come up with your calculations and you figure out an angle, we're going to want to be picking the smaller of the 2 angles that you might get in order to put into the machine and try and see whether or not you can hit the box.